Kya Rahi Hu is the charming, light-hearted yet profound tale of a man inspired by his grandfather to seek the wisdom of the Arthashastra. Journey with modern-day disciple of Chanakya as he goes from being an aimless youth to the richest man in the world, inspiring a whole nation to take up study of Sanskrit and ancient Indian literature for business success. The story about you and your journey through life. While you attend this session, you may well find yourself walking the hero's path to bring out the Chanakya into you. This session is not truly for the selective class of people. It can be attended by a parent or a young adult, by a business tycoon or an academic scholar with equal ease and interest. This is the topic that makes you think. Chanakya, also known as Vishnugupta and Kautilya, he was the leadership guru par excellence. He lived in 3rd century BC. His book, Kautilya's Arthashastra, has 6,000 sutras, which have been classified into 15 books, 150 chapters, and 180 topics by Chanakya himself. In our day-to-day life, we miss to get the information of such gurus and the learning from what they have given to the society. On 30th May 2018, Dr. Radhakrishnan Pillai will be decoding the crux of teaching of Chanakya that are for the daily life in the session of Knowledge Series, organized by SDR Knowledge Foundation in association with Chitnavis Center. Corporate Chanakya, this book is written by a well-known author, Mr. Radhakrishnan, fondly known as Chanakya Pillai. Educated in the field of management and qualified as an international management consultant, he later turned to discover management from Indian roots and proceeded to do Master in Sanskrit and PhD. He started a company, Atma Darshan, in field of spiritual tourism and has over 17 years of industry experience. He is the recipient of Sardar Patel International Award 09 for his research in Kautilya's Arthashastra and spreading Chanakya's teachings. He is well acclaimed at bringing the learnings of Chanakya and relating it to modern corporate culture and business dynamics. Let's meet him then. Thank you.
Very patient. They have arrived here. And we are going to start the program in 5 minutes. Before that, I would like to introduce again about SGR Knowledge Foundation. SGR Knowledge Foundation is a Section 8 company. And under this company, we are conducting various events. Like Knowledge Series is one event of SGR Knowledge Foundation. And various programs for the underprivileged people. Like in education, health and knowledge, we are conducting all these sessions. And accordingly, we have started a computer bus also, which have covered around 2,000 students, MNC 2,000 students, and around 500 NGO underprivileged students of Bhotli village there in Kuttipori. And accordingly, this foundation is conducting various programs also. In this knowledge series, this is the 5th program. And I'm very thankful to all the audiences present here that you people have accepted the delay and coordinated with us. And we are going to start the program in some time. So as sir is here, he will take at least 3 minutes to reach here now. Thank you. Now all wait is over now. So, I will not take much time of yours, and I need not to introduce Radhakrishnan sir, as Shreya has already introduced him, and we had gone through the review of a book also. So, without taking much time of yours, I request Chairman Raisoni Group of Institution, Mr. Sunil Raisoni, to please welcome Pillai sir. Partner for this knowledge series, and in association with Chitnavis Center, we are conducting this knowledge series every month. I request Director Chitnavis Center, Mr. Mohan Savade, to please welcome him with a sapling and a floral bouquet.
It has been our national support and Sagar Kakare, our student of graduation CCSC, that he was there always to give the status about where he is. Thank you, Sagar. Thank you again. I won't take much time of yours and I will hand over the session to Pillai sir.
A warm good evening. Respected Rajan Vedukar sir and the whole family at SGR group and of course Hectavis Center. So all of us have been waiting, even I have been waiting to come here. But you know, 2.5 hours delay from Bombay was never expected. Never in my life I got so delayed. But then you say ki, instead of looking at the past, thoda aage ko dekhte hai. So the first thing I was confirming, kitna der aur baat kar rahe hai. So they said we can speak for 1.5 hours. Oh my goodness. I said I'll speak for 1 hour only. But I'll make sure we try and cover up whatever we are lost in time. So before I go to the topic, which is Chanakya, I want to start with a joke about getting late. Because it was not under my control. And supposed to be the best airlines that was booked in was Indigo, which is supposed to be punctual, right? And somebody told me, I know the CFO of Indigo Railway, I mean Airways, not Airways. So he was telling me that they have a very interesting strategy. Agar flight ka time 1.5 ghanta hai, to pehla bolte 2 ghanta hai. And even if they are delayed by 20 minutes, they say we are 10 minutes before time. So you take the best airline, which is supposed to be always punctual, and they always claim that 99% on time to show it to their investors. You know, so you're on records, you are always before time. So actually 1.5 hours, they show 2 hours, and with delay, they have already factored in the extra. In spite of having Indigo, instead of doing the web check-in, in spite of me reaching 2 hours before time, that's more important, at the airport. So our flight was supposed to take off at 4 o'clock, we were there at 2 o'clock. And then, no weather problem in Bombay, everything was clear. But then, the fact is that we are supposed to start at 8:15, we are here. So let me start with a joke. The joke is like this, one husband promises a wife that I will take you out for a movie and a dinner. All wives will be happy, right? Husband promises. Ask me lokar yeto, I'll come early, I will take you out for a dinner. Now, the promised time is 6:30, right? And it so happens that the husband gets stuck up somewhere in office work and all those things. 6:30, 7, 7:30, the lady is dressed up. Very much clear that I want to go out for dinner, movie and everything. Finally, he comes at 8:15. But before that, what happens is that the lady gets so angry, you know, it's so natural, we have got ready to actually go out for a nice date with her own husband. But it so happened that the moment she realizes ki ye to hamesha aisa hi hai, she changes her dress, takes off all the ornaments and all those things, and she just wears a nightgown, pajamas and all those things, and moh latka ke baithi hai. 8:15, the door bell rings, and the husband says, chalo, chalo, yaar. You missed a movie, but I have already booked another one and let's go. The moment ting tong, par bhai samo raste, and completely in a nightgown. And you know what the husband says? I gave you 2 hours extra and still you are not ready? Nahi bhi tu ushira karte, husband! So the idea is that you know whom to blame, right? So friends, coming back, a lot of things are under our control and a lot of things are not under our control. But there is one thing which we can always keep under our control, that is our mind. And that is where Chanakya comes in. The Chanakya, we will today look at this particular session as a person who has various dimensions. But what is very important is that Chanakya is very practical. And I have been very fortunate that actually I have been studying, teaching, researching, and doing a lot of work in the field of Chanakya for the last 20 years. And at Mumbai University, local sir has been there as my mentor guide also, where we have done a lot of fantastic work as a research project and a lot of things. But given the time limitation that we have is that, it is like, you know, telling Mahabharata in half an hour. But then, good orators know this, 100 baat ki ek baat. Aur zarurat pade to ek baat ki 100 baat. So, you know, the time management about knowledge is very different. It is not about a watch. It is about the impact you make. So, if somebody wants to tell the whole story of Ramayana, you can tell it in four lines also. एक राजा था, उसको बच्चे नहीं थे, फिर एक ने किया, चार लड़के हो गए, फिर बाद में एक को वनवास का संदर्श आया, पिता के हार्ट अटैक से मर गए, मन में बहुत समय हो गया, फिर उनकी बीवी सीता जी को रावण लेके गए, फिर वानर सेना के साथ सीता माता को वापस लेके आ गए, रावण को डिफीट किया और राम राज्य की स्थापना हो गई, हो गया रामायण खत्म. That is Sankshep Ramayana, Char Ovayun. But then if you go into the Ramayana in detail, you go into every particular character. And you said, okay, Ram, Maryada Purushottam. What is the meaning of Maryada Purushottam? Sita, what does she define? Where did Sita come from? Sita came from a place and a father is a great Raja Rishi called Janak. And then you describe Janak. And then you go on to say there are four brothers, but each of the brother has got a different personality. There are three mothers. And then you say, are Ramayana itna detail mein ja sakte hain kya? Because everything about Ramayana, then you go into different characters, like, you know, we have somebody like Hanuman, who is a Pandit. Now, this beauty of a great scholar of any particular subject is that, if required, if the audience is ready, if the students is ready, they can go into the details and expand it. But if required, they say audience ready nahi hai, to compact it. Ek baat ki sau baat. One small Ramayana can be expanded. That's also a good skill of a great orator and teacher. And the other way around also. Bahut sara kam mein bata. All depends on the audience. And the people who are ready to learn. Given an opportunity, I would say my introduction to Chanakya that I will be giving you in the little time that I have is only the tip of the iceberg. But my happiness would be that after this program ends, you actually begin your journey of understanding Chanakya differently. Because there is one aspect of Chanakya which all of us know. Okay? The great Chanakya. But there is another aspect of Chanakya which many people don't know. That's what I'm going to bring about. And what is more important, if you look at our topic, it's actually Chanakya in daily life. So, in my particular lecture, I'm going to give you in sankshep, in short, three aspects of Chanakya. Chanakya the person, Chanakya his knowledge and wisdom, and third is Chanakya in daily life, its application. So, let me start with the first part of it. Chanakya the person. Indian history cannot be complete without Chanakya. Because if you look at all great men and women who walked on this particular great land of Bharat, India, there are many, many people who have influenced and done their part of their work. This is called as a karma bhumi, tapo bhumi, moksha bhumi, all those things. But if you look at our history, traditional knowledge, there are some people who stand out, right? And they are generally people who have left an impact on their generation and generations to come. And there are many. There are people who are regionally known, there are people who are nationally known, and there are some people who are internationally known. So if you look at the Maharashtra Santa Parampara, you know, a lot of saints locally may not be known abroad or may not be known at the India level also. So Gargiya Maharaj. But so many kind of a people, they are very, very popular in this part of the country, but not necessarily outside. But there are certain people who have an impact for many generations, but also have an impact nationally and internationally. So one such personality who is a world personality from India is Chanakya. And this I am not telling because I am very proud to be a student of Chanakya. This I have tested and verified in my travels across the globe. I have travelled to at least 15 countries and I have taught in some of the best universities, right, from the Oxford and the Cambridge and many countries like Singapore and US. And I was very surprised that what we think as Chanakya in India is also very popular abroad. So I'm going to talk about a personality who is known in India but also known across the globe, and his contribution, I'm going to speak about it, is amazing. So coming back to who was Chanakya, all of us know about him, right? He's a real character. He's not, you know, sometimes we get into doubt, hey, vyakti hote ka, because Indian history is so vast, it was much before history was started documented in the other parts of the world. Well, most of the document, if you look at it from the Christian era, you know, Even if you look at 2018, it's a very Western way of documenting or dating, isn't it? But the fact remains is that our documentation dating started so many years back that sometimes some of these characters will even wonder aisa ye sach hai ki kalpanik hai. That's why we have this interesting word called as mythology. Mythology comes from myth. Chanakya is not a myth. Chanakya is real. He lived in the 4th century BC. There are enough documents to prove that there was a person who lived. And geographically, he lived in a place and operated in a place called as Magad. And the capital of Magad kingdom during those days was Pataliputra, which is modern day Bihar, called as Patna. Now, I again and again emphasize on this particular point that Chanakya is real, because Chanakya cannot be put into the league of mythology. Because ये काल्पनिक नहीं है, उसके काफी documents हैं. What happened is that I tell you that many times when we watch this so-called modern versions of old characters, sometimes we don't know which is real or not. For example, all of you know about Bhim in Mahabharata, one of the 5 Pandavas. But we also know, especially the young children, there is a character called as Chota Bhim. See, the little girl is very happy. I have 2 kids, you know, they are fans of Chota Bhim. And by the way, there is a company which made millions of rupees by on that character called Chota Bhim. I don't know if you are aware of it, they made movies, cartoons. Is Chota Bhim real? But it's based on a character called Bhim which was real, right? So same way, there are versions of Chanakya you will find, and I want to warn over here that many of the WhatsApp messages you find are actually not Chanakya sayings. Huh? चाणक्य ने कहा था, हमें बोला कहां कहां था पता नहीं. एंड टेलीविजन डायलॉग्स इन मेनी ऑफ द चाणक्य सीरियल्स आर कंसीडर्ड चाणक्य सीन. नो दैट द स्क्रिप्ट राइटर्स क्रिएटिविटी, उसको भी ना माने हम, बट दे आर नॉट नेसेसरी ओरिजिनल चाणक्य. सो आई वांट टू डिफरेंशिएट द काल्पनिक चाणक्य वर्सेस द रियल चाणक्य. आई एम गोना स्पीक विद द रियल चाणक्य बिकॉज आई कम फ्रॉम अ रिसर्च बैकग्राउंड. आई एम ऑल्सो एन एकेडमिशियन. And we academicians cannot do, you know, kalpanik. We are not fiction writers. We are supposed to be research authentic writers. So coming back, you know, this whole thing about real and, you know, characters. I remember this, that 2 years ago, we had this opportunity to be part of the government of India's one of the flagship programs, which is called the International Yoga Day, right? So this year I've been very fortunate, sir. Actually, now I'm going to travel to USA. 21st June I'll be there, represent India for the International Yoga Conference in New York in United Nations. And we're taking a delegation of 30 people. So I got this opportunity 2 years back when it was happening in Chandigarh. And when in Chandigarh we went, we had all the big yoga gurus, you know, right from Baba Ramdev. We had Dr. Nagendra, who's from the S. Vyasa University, another great yoga guru. Then we had, of course, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, all of these stalwarts. I remember this since I was the main coordinator along with some of my professors from Bombay University. So we had this opportunity to actually host Baba Ramdev as an organizer. Okay? It was very interesting. It was a government program and, you know, and I remember that we were in a room, very closed door room, myself and a few organizers and Baba Ramdev sitting and chatting for hours together. And then, you know, with famous personality, you take out your mobile and selfie, right? Like selfie, yeah. And then I remember my wife Surekha is also, you know, and I have 2 kids, you know, they are, now they are 7 and 5 years old, they were 2 years younger at that particular time. I took a WhatsApp and sent it to them, and I remember when I came back to Bombay, my little children, suddenly my daughter asked me, Papa, Baba Ramdev sachi ka hai kya? For a moment, you see. And of course, thanks to my wife, she's like, you don't understand child psychology, we mothers understand it. Then, as she was explaining, I got that what is the kind of image the children create, because they are continuously watching the TV, right? And there are many imaginary characters, Superman, Robin Hood, I don't know, there are many, many Pokemon, Doraemon, some petrol, what petrol is that? Power petrol, ye to pata bhi nahi hai, little kids may know it. So when you are continuously watching these channels, Patanjali suddenly puts an ad with Baba Ramdev. And the image of Baba Ramdev, ye bhi shayad cartoon character hoga. You know, think about it. Oh, ye bhi hua hai. So somewhere the child's mind says ki Baba Ramdev uska sab jagah photo dekh raha hai, you know. Maybe he's not real. And then suddenly Papa's photo with him. And then I realized, oh my goodness, this may be true with Baba Ramdev, who is living in this generation, but it may be true with Chanakya also. Ki Chanakya, bahut sare mein said, no, friends, I am trying to separate ki there was a person who lived in India in flesh and blood. He did amazing work. So what are the works that he did? Amazingly, first things first, he defeated Alexander when he came to India, okay? You may be aware that India had so many international attacks, but the first international attack that happened was Alexander, and Chanakya defeated it. And I wish we continued Chanakya, we wouldn't have another international attacks. But what is very interesting is that in the same lifetime, he was facing internal problem. Till Chanakya's period, they were ghar ke jhagde. Mahabharata, Ramayana, they were all geographically same place. But internationally, first time, we had somebody from a different culture, from the Greek culture, Alexander coming. But Alexander was stopped, he could not get into India after a particular point of time. He is the one who defeated Dhananand, who was a very powerful king of the Nanda dynasty. But what is very interesting is that the ninth king of the Nanda dynasty, Dhananand, was defeated but replaced by an able student of Chanakya, and his name is Chandragupta Maurya. And that's why he is known as the kingmaker of Chandragupta Maurya, right? So the Guru, the Raj Guru. So two problems parallelly, internal problems, Dhananand, Bharga problem, Alexander, both simultaneously solved. And so influential and so important for politicians that when we ask, you know, konsa problem pehle solve karna hai, ghar ka problem ya bhar ka problem, which will you solve? Both. You don't have a choice, right? So Chanakya's first thing is that all problems have to be solved simultaneously. You can't say, you know, one problem ka dusra problem. No, everything comes, you have to attack it strategically, of course. So that is the story's part of it. Other important part of it is that Chanakya realized that when he made Chandragupta Maurya the king, making somebody who has got no background about leadership, you train him up. And that's very important to know, because India, even now, I don't know if we understand why we give so much about this caste thing. And let me tell you, it is such a confused thing, but in our country we always give opportunity, and Chanakya is a prime example where it is said Chandragupta Maurya was actually a Dasi Putra. Now Dasi means she was a poor lady, she was a servant, and he saw a talent in a young boy in a village. He takes him, trains and makes him India's biggest samrat. So we have a great lesson from Chanakya that talent should be given training and training should be given opportunity. Three are important, na? Bahut sare log hote hain jo talented hote hain, lekin unko opportunity nahi milti, right? Lekin talented logon ko bhi training ki zarurat padti hai. And in this country, it is now that we have started to understand the importance of training. So Chanakya spotted Chandragupta Maurya as a talent. He trained him up for 14-15 years and then gave an opportunity to become a king. And Chanakya also realized that usko rajagaddi pe bitha diya, that is not enough. When you are in the seat of a leadership position, you have great impact and influence, isn't it true? So when you are a king, or when I say king, not only of a political kingdom, at any administrative position, at any academic position, at maybe a sarpanch level, or maybe a community leader, you are chairman of a company or a samaj, you know, you got thousands of people who will just listen to you, right? But Chanakya realized one thing, giving the position, the power to Chandragupta Maurya is not enough. We need to give him structures of how to run the kingdom, isn't it? If you look at, after 1947, the greatest contribution that was done by the leaders of that generation is making the Indian constitution, isn't it? And let me tell you, that was a very important exercise that they did. Because even today, if there is a debate, discussion, we go back to that document called as the Indian constitution, isn't it? So if you look at Rajendra Prasad, if you look at Baba Saheb Ambedkar, all the leaders that sat together, they debated, discussed, and finally they brought out a document which is almost like our reference book whenever there is a challenge. Chanakya wrote the first constitution for India, and that is called the Kautilya's Arthashastra. Because Raja to bana diya, but then when Raja has a problem, where does he go to? He can go to two people. One is a Rajguru. He will tell you what to do. But the thing is that the process has been documented. And I'm going to, of course, speak on that. But what is very interesting is that Chanakya believed that you should have a book for reference, the rule book, right? but never get stuck up by the rule of the book. This is where the negativity of bureaucracy comes in. You know what does they say about bureaucracy? What is bureaucracy? Bureaucracy means the person who always tells you the rules, 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 rules. And somewhere it has become such a negative thing about bureaucracy that kuch hota hi nahi hai. But let me tell you, the real whole thing about bureaucracy is actually good administration. A bureaucrat should know the rules. That's why most of the bureaucrats are highly educated, isn't it? But the fact also remains that a bureaucrat should not get stuck up by the rules. Respect the rules, don't break the rules, but go beyond the rules to achieve the results. Very, very important. When Arthashastra was written, Chanakya said, I'm giving you a guideline, I'm giving you a book called Arthashastra. Anytime you want, you can refer to it. So it's called a ready reference manual for a leader. देखो अभी दो कैदी आ गए और दो गुनेगार आ गए, निर्णय कैसे लेना है? He कौन है? He doesn't know, he's just become a Raja, because when you are a leader, you have to take decisions, right? So at that particular time you refer, what do the rule books say? Okay. So Chanakya's greatest contribution is that all that he created, he documented. There are two books of course dedicated to him. One is called Kautilya Arthashastra. The second one is called Chanakya Niti. And many of you know about this. But there are two separate books. Chanakya Niti has got 360 odd sutras, while Arthashastra has got 6000 sutras. So what is the difference? It's like watching a trailer and watching a movie. Yeah? So movie is always bigger, right? Bahubali ka dekha na kitna bada movie, part 1, part 2. But the trailer is almost a sankshep, a little condensed form of the movie just to attract you. Many of us know about the book called Chanakya Niti, right? You read it, it is all available across India. You can find it in the railway stall, airport, wherever. It's a very popular book. In fact, I say it's one of the best sellers of all time. No requirement of marketing. So Chanakya Niti is there. But many people forget that the bigger version, the full movie, is actually the Kautilya Arthashastra, which has got 6000 sutras. So now, I completed part A, telling you the story of Chanakya, what he did. But I'm going to talk about the knowledge part of Chanakya, which is unfortunately lost to our generation. Very few people today actually study the Arthashastra. I've been very fortunate that I actually went to Kerala. I studied under Guru Dr. Gangadhar Nair, a great Sanskrit scholar. And I studied each of the 6000 sutras word by word. Okay? And I said, oh my goodness, here is one man who actually wrote 6000 formulas of how to be a great leader. Ek formula E is equal to MC square. Einstein ne bana diya. Great contribution, right? And it actually made him one of the most brilliant persons who walked on the one formula. One theory of relativity. But multiplied 360 times, that's Chanakya Niti. And multiplied 6000 times, that's Arthashastra. Can you believe the kind of a wealth? And when people say 6000, I said Mahabharata is 1 lakh. So that is the kind of a knowledge that we have in this country. Unfortunately, they are only in the libraries, discussed by a few academicians like us. But when I read this, I said, no, we need to practice Chanakya from the books to actually apply it in our daily life. That's very, very important. If you don't apply Chanakya in daily life, then Chanakya is only a good figure to be respected. No. And I tell you, the Arthashastra reference are not there only in Arthashastra, it is there in various other Indian scriptures. In fact, in the Jain culture, in the lot of these particular books, which are there in the Tibetan culture, by the way, there are references of Chanakya. Are you aware of this? So in the Jaina philosophy also we have influence of Chanakya, in the Buddhist philosophies, all these philosophies have existed. There is so much reference. Just to give you an out of the box, there is a very popular book in India and great Indian scripture called Srimad Bhagavatam. Eknathi Bhagavat asana Marathi vane. So there are different Bhagavats. In the 12th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a mention of Chanakya. So Chanakya is such an influence in Indian society. My Guru Dr. Gangadhar Nair used to tell that hamare pratyek vyakti ke andar ek Chanakya chupa hai. But usko jagane ki zarurat hai. So in India, it's a very common thing. For example, we use words like, you know, Samadana Dandavyana. It's Chanakya Niti. Dushman ka dushman dost, enemy is a friend. So these are very popular ones. Ya phir paisa paise ko khichta hai. Have you heard about this? In fact, there is a saying in the business community, first you go behind money. And when you know the secrets of money, money comes behind you. Isn't it true? So these are the kind of a small things which we know traditionally, but unfortunately we haven't done real research on it. I've been very fortunate that, you know, I started creating some of the knowledge outputs out of this Arthashastra. So I'll move on to the second part of it. What is the knowledge that is available in Arthashastra and Chanakya Niti? How many of you have read Chanakya Niti? Please start. Okay? And even if you don't want to put your money, just go to the internet and download Chanakya Niti free mein mil jayega. But I'm telling you, friends, imagine you have a great grandfather who was one of the richest person in the world. Hum us kul ke hai, isn't it? Maybe you are not rich, that's okay. But at least you value that great grandfather who had so much wealth and knowledge, isn't it? So all our great Rishi Parampara was knowledge era. We were the richest country in the world not because we had money or trading systems. We were the richest because we had knowledge systems. And in that huge parampara of knowledge, I'm just quoting one person called Chanakya. But you know, we have to get influence to go back and study and do research. And the government of India many years ago started a project on national manuscriptology. I don't know if you heard about this project. So they said, you know, how many manuscripts are there? And they started finding out. Initially they started by going to libraries of big universities, old universities like Mysore, Travancore, which is now in Kerala. And they started finding out. And they found that there were so many manuscripts still there, but people are not doing research on it. For example, Mysore University, where the original Arthashastra is there of Chanakya, has got 80,000 manuscripts in one single library. 80,000. But oh, achha hai, hamare paas hai, koi value nahi karta, research nahi karta. But in that kind of a process, they started realizing that India's knowledge is not necessarily in libraries of universities, it is also there in families. For example, the Jyotish Parampara, the Ayurved Parampara is in a family, isn't it? Shilpa Shastra was passed on in the family. And you'd be surprised to know there are families which have documented process of that knowledge. And they started going into it and they found out there are so many houses even now. And probably one of your houses that Azobansa te kaitari tumchakade taadpatra se. But we don't know how to read it, how to understand it. So when this whole process started, they realized National Manuscriptology, please go to the website of Government of India. There are more than 1 crore manuscripts still available in this generation. Of different subjects, they categorized into some 2000 subjects. I'm talking about Chanakya. Now I'm going to give you a few examples of how our rishis, including Chanakya, would give that great knowledge which is applicable in daily life. So I'll give you one example of Chanakya Niti, the book. And the best part about the formulas or the sutras that our rishis wrote was very simple to understand even for a child or even for a grandfather. Not complicated. For example, if I talk about E is equal to MC square, for a common man you need to understand the background of physics, isn't it? So we need to orient him. But the sutras that Chanakya wrote in Chanakya Niti or even Vidura wrote in Vidura Niti and all those books were very simple. You don't require too much of orientation. So I will just give you one example of Chanakya Niti. Chanakya says, be careful of three things. If you know how to be positive with them, they will give you warmth, they will take care of you. They will be very, very positive. But if you don't know how to take care of the three things, they will finish you. See, look at your psychology. What are those three things? So the formula itself gives you like a marketing angle of looking at wo kya teen cheez hai which can give you everything that you want, warm, support. But if you don't know how to use it, they will finish you. You know what Chanakya Niti says in that sutra? Three things. First thing is called fire, agni, aag. And it says, we human beings exist because of agni. Even in the Rig Veda, which is supposed to be the highest first Veda, it starts with agni, you know. You'd be surprised, we exist because of the sun, isn't it? Human beings. And in our houses also, if we don't have fire, we don't exist, isn't it? You see, the first thing that we do when we go to Graha Pravesh is actually worship the agni, even in weddings, isn't it? So agni devata. And that's why we call it house warming ceremony, isn't it? Warm up, heat. That's knowledge representation. It's like fire, jis ghar pe nahi hai. Of course, you can give modern things, you know, electricity, microwave, all this is fine. the finding that heat and fire jahan pe hai, jahan pe agni hai, it will give you warm support. And look at the other thing. If you don't know how to use agni and be careful to it, respect it, if you don't do that, it can finish you, isn't it? Wo wahi agni jo ghar ko bacha sakta hai, wo ghar ko jala bhi sakta hai. So first remember agni. Second he says, which is very very useful, but also can have a counter effect to you, is snake. Sarpa. Snake, sarpa, samjhane, saap. And I started doing, because all these ancient scriptures sometimes you have to use decoding, you know. Samjhane. And I did not understand ki why is it snake is useful, but if you don't know how, it will finish you. It will finish me, I know. But how is snake useful? And I got an influence and I got an understanding of how useful snake is when I actually started training the Indian Army. Do you know anybody with the army background here? Okay, there you are. I want you to watch a movie called as Prahar. Have you seen the movie Prahar? If not, go back. It's a very beautiful movie. Nana Patekar was a hero. It showed about Indian Army. So there's an institution called as National Defense College where I'm a lecturer. I go there and teach Chanakya's war principle. So, you know, the army people work in the jungles. And you know, if there is no ration, they have to eat something. So what does a common man do whenever you are feeling hungry and you are in a jungle? There are different types of fruits and flowers available, right? But you are in an unknown area, in a jungle, you don't know whether that fruit is good fruit or a poisonous fruit, right? It may look very nice. And Chanakya says that the only thing that you can eat in an unknown place is actually snake. Snake? Yes, that's why they taught how to catch it. The only place where the snake can have an impact on you is its poisonous teeth, isn't it? So even the cobra that you have, if you know how to tackle it, or uska the poison name nikal do, you know you can consume the whole body, and that flesh is also important for you to survive. That's why if you look at many countries, which are deserted countries or surrounded by deserts, they eat all these things that's walking around, including snakes. Have you heard about it? I'm not here to take veg or non-veg, it's a survival. Now look about it, that look about this, that snake can save you in the deepest of the jungles because you're hungry, you don't know what to do, what to eat. But at the same time, if you don't know how to catch the snake, the snake will kill you completely. The first is agni, second is snake. You know which is the third one? Very interesting. He says, aisa ek vyakti hai जो आपको बहुत संभाल सकता है लेकिन अगर आपने अपने मर्यादा क्रॉस किया वो आपको खत्म कर देगा. यू नो हु इज ही? द राजा, द किंग. यू नो दिस ऑलवेज इज सेइंग दैट द किंग्स मेन आर मोर पावरफुल देन द किंग. हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट इट? सो द नंबर टू, जिसको अमात्य भी बोलते हैं, मंत्री भी बोलते हैं, बराबर है? मंत्री इज लाइक, यू नो, ए राजा के साथ अपॉइंटमेंट यू गो थ्रू मी, द पीएस ऑफ लॉट ऑफ पावरफुल पीपल, पर्सनल असिस्टेंट्स. Very, very powerful. And the advice given is, listen, you are in the care of the king. If you are under the influence of a great person, understand things, that's your power. Because uski chhatra chhaya mein. But if you misuse it and if you break the trust of that king, he will finish you, isn't it? See, in the government bureaucracy also, you know, some people get into this whole thing that, you know, I am powerful. But there is one thing which many people don't know. There is something called the confidential report. Have you ever heard of it? So why am I telling you all these things, friends? If you are in the influence of a powerful person, be humble. Use the power, he will give you everything that you want, he will take care of you. Because the king's man is equally treated like a king, isn't it? But the moment the king says, no, you have broken my trust, he will completely finish you off. So, look at this small one sutra which I explained. Three things you should be careful of. Not misuse it, but use it and it will take care of you. Agni, that is fire. Fire, snake and king. Now moving on to Arthashastra. Arthashastra, as I told you, is like a manual. I want all of you to read it. I know, everybody gets afraid of the 6000 sutras. Don't worry about it. I have written 8 books on Chanakya. I have used some of them. So if you are very worried about starting with the 8000 in Sanskrit, it's okay. Read some of my books. But I want to tell you, what is the content of this 8000 sutras? The first content about this 8000 sutras is that, pehli baat, it is a Raja Vidya. It is meant for leaders and kings. Now you may wonder, I am not a leader. It is not meant for me. It is the other way around. It is an open book for everybody who wants to be a leader. लीडर लोग को तो पढ़ना ही पढ़ना है, बट किसी को लीडर बनना है तो पढ़ो. See what happened is that somewhere a lot of people say that, you know, this knowledge is not meant for you. It is wrong. Knowledge is always universal and always requires a student who can learn it. So anybody who wants to be a leader in any field should study Chanakya. So Chanakya is about Rajavidya, right? And he's a Rajaguru. So the whole sutras about how to think like a leader is given in Arthashastra. I will touch upon 4-5 points just to give you an idea. There are 180 topics in Arthashastra. It is actually containing 15 books, 6000 sutras, 150 chapters and 180 topics. And I remember in my early stages when I was trying to study Arthashastra, I read a Western scholar writing about it. And he said, Arthashastra is not a book, it is a library. Chanakya is not a person, he is an institution. Because you'd be surprised, 180 topics includes things like philosophy, things like training of a king, selection of a king, training of amatyas and ministers, how to run the administration, how to fill the treasury, because treasury is important, right? Criminal psychology, policing, international laws, international policies, labor unions, and communities ke saath kaise lead karna hai, because we have community leaders also. Warfare strategies. It just goes on. Gemology, Ayurveda, architecture, everything combined into one book. And Bhishmacharya says in Mahabharata, Raja Vidya iti Parama Vidya. What does it mean? A Raja should know all Vidyas, and the combination of all Vidyas is Raja Vidya. A leader cannot say, you know, I don't know this particular subject. Okay, you may not be a specialist, but then you should know what is the basics of it, right? So if you look at the Prime Minister or the President of a country, so he may not be a specialist, but he will have advisors who will tell them what is it about that field, isn't it? So have you heard about the position in India, the government of India, called as Chief Economist? There's a position and there's a person also. So the President, who is supposed to be the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, and the Prime Minister, who is looking at all the other work, when they don't know about economics, they go to that particular person. Then there is a position called NSA. What does NSA mean? National Security Advisor. So I may not be trained in security, but there is a person. Okay? So a person like a king, a leader, should have so many people surrounding himself who are experts with their particular vidyas. So somebody may be an expert in geography, somebody may be expert in technology, somebody may be expert in a language. And a Raja has to get surrounded by such people taki unki Raja Vidya mein sare vidya aa jate hain. Okay? So Arthashastra is a book of so many different topics combined into one. Since it's not an Arthashastra lecture, I want to just tell you that this book is not just a book of the past. You will be surprised, it was used by kings till our previous generation, last 100 years ago. Including I was at Baroda, and I remember meeting somebody from Swaraj Gharana. बोलते हमारे यहाँ पे इवन कंट्रीज लाइक नेपाल एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स उनके राजाओं के शादी होती थी ना विद इन देयर ओन अलायंसेस. इट सीम्स अ पंडित जी वुड कम होम. देयर यूज्ड टू बी होम स्कूलिंग ड्यूरिंग दोस डेज, यू नो, नॉट अ प्रॉपर स्कूल. दे शुड कम एंड टीच चाणक्य नीति एंड अर्थशास्त्र. देन आई सेड ओके, थ्री जनरेशन ago, यस वी वर लर्निंग. एंड इवन छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज हैज बीन नोन टू यूज स्ट्रैटेजीज ऑफ अर्थशास्त्र. And this document is about Samartha Ramdas, who himself was a great scholar, right? His guru teaching him strategies. For example, the 400 forts that we have in Maharashtra of Shivaji's times, you know what is the word that is used? Durga. But Kila bolo to nahi, Durga bolo to na. Kila is also equal to Durga, but the word Durga comes from the Arthashastra. And then there is a concept called as Ashtapradhan. Barobar? Maine Ashtadhyaksha ke Ashtapradhan bolta hai. This is a concept that comes from the Arthashastra. Shivaji's administration was very close to Chanakya's administration. Now this is Shivaji I'm talking about being in Maharashtra. When I go back to Kerala, I come from Thiruvananthapuram. I mean, my parents come from there. And it was supposed to be one of the very well organized states, you know, Travancore. Even there, traditionally, those families used to study Arthashastra. In Punjab, I found that. I found that in Mysore, Now, why am I telling you is that maybe in the last 100-150 years we have forgotten what Arthashastra is, but let me tell you, friends, it had a great influence on Indian thinking because we knew all the strategies. Unfortunately, we had a bad time and, you know, we had foreign influence, but so on. But now that India has come back to its own metal, we need to go back to our own roots. Now, coming back, I'm going to the third part of it. I give you some idea about Arthashastra, I give you some idea of Chanakya. Now, I'm going to talk about Chanakya in daily life. How do you practice Chanakya? For that, I'm going to take one chapter from the Arthashastra, which comes in book number one. It's called Vidya Samudeshana, the Vidya for a Raja. Raja Vidya, what are the Vidyas? Big topic on that. Basically, the syllabus for leadership training. Okay, and then in that first book, there are 21 chapters, The Making of a King. And the chapter number 19 in Sanskrit, it is called Raja Pranidhi. Raja ka Pranidhi, that means the activity of a king. Raja ka activity kya hona chahiye? And in very simple words, it is called the daily timetable of a king. Daily life hai na hamara topic. What you should do daily. And he is actually given a timetable. If you look at when we were in schools, na, we are more disciplined. When we go to colleges, universities, 75% minimum attendance. What 75% minimum attendance? You are a full-time student, 100% attendance. And you know, I like the school discipline much better because even if one day you don't go, there is a remark on the calendar, isn't it? And the parents have to answer you, why did you not come? And that is how the whole thing gets into discipline. But the moment you go to college, the uniform that's where your life's basic things get shaken. Actually, in the youth, you should be more disciplined. And the youth energy is getting dissipated. No. Unfortunately, the daily timetable that we follow in schools, unfortunately, doesn't get followed later on, right? And that's where our country is also like this only. You'd be surprised that when we are going to school, there is a timetable that happens in the family. Have you seen that? Vacation, everybody, all parents go on vacation along with the children. But the moment the schools are starting, I don't know about Nagpur cycle, but 15th of June it will start. Everybody is going shopping for uniforms, isn't it? Books. So our whole timetable is around the timetable of the child, isn't it? So what is happening is that, why do we actually forget that you also need to have self-discipline when you grow up? And especially for a Raja also, there is a daily timetable. It can't be loose, it has to be tight. So this chapter called Raja Pranidhi actually has got a daily timetable of a king. And I am going to speak about a few of those ideas which we can practice in our daily life. So, today, how many hours do we have in a day? Sure? 24 hours aaye ki nahi? Chanakya ke time mein kitne taas hote hain? Kaise kya 24 hours hai? So what I'm telling you is that nothing changes. Suraj bhi hoyi hai, tara bhi hoyi hai, sab hoyi hai. So remember one thing, that even if you're talking about a book which was written 2004 years ago, 24 hours is 24 hours only, even today. But they say successful people are not the one who got extra hours. Successful people know how to manage that 24 hours, isn't it? So in the Arthashastra, Chanakya has defined what you should do at what time. Subah subah uthne ka. What time do we average get up? School days, the school decides you have to get up. Even parents have to get up, right? But if you were to decide a timetable of your own with a choice, when will you get up? 6 o'clock? I don't know. One good thing about India is that we are becoming health conscious. So, aajkal raste pe log chalte, jogging karte dikhte. So we say, in a good system, you should get up before sunrise. Isn't it? That's a good system. But can you believe what time Chanakya advises the king to get up? 4 o'clock? Brahma Muhurtam. Can you believe? It's 1:30 in the night. Yeah, Raja hai. Actually, bahut sare kaam raat ko hote hain. Raja Vidya, also Gohiya Vidya. Do you know when you take an oath as a president or a prime minister, we forget a very important thing. There is something called as a presidential oath. But next time TV mein dekhna, along with the presidential oath, they take one more oath, which we don't give importance to. It's called oath of secrecy. Are you aware of this? Because ek baar raja ban gaye, ha, then you come to know there is a different parallel system that runs. Are you aware of this? And that is not supposed to be known to everybody. You also take an oath of secrecy. Whatever be the media trying to bring it out, it can't be bought out. It is not the wrong thing about the media. There is certain things only matured people can understand, and government is supposed to be a very matured way of handling things, right? It's like, you know, the certain things you will not understand till you reach there. Why not? Till the father is dead, the son will never become a man. Swami Vivekananda said this. You may be 60-year-old. But jab tak pitaji hai na, 85-year-old wale, tab tak aap ladke hi ho. But the day the father dies, you become responsible, isn't it? You suddenly feel, arre, I'm the head of the family. So when you're a leader, you have to understand your time cycle is 24 hours, but the work cycle is very different. So what Chanakya does, 24 hours, he divides into two parts. So how many hours each? 12 hours, right? And then he further divides 24 hours into small units of 1.5 hours. So, ded ghante ka cycles hai. So, 24 hours divided by 1.5 hours, how many?
16.
8 ghanta, one cycle, 8 ghanta, another cycle. Correct? And when I started doing some research, and what is the logic of 1.5 hours? And one Western time management person told me this. You know what? Human beings cannot sit at one place and do one thing constantly for more than 1.5 hours. You require a break, isn't it? That's why English movies is 1.5 hours. You can't sit, attention span is not there. That's why when they sit in, you have to speak for 1 hour 15 minutes and you're taking it. I mean, already made it, I can. Otherwise, you have to give a break. Even in seminars and conferences or full days program, have you seen that? 1.5 hours ka session, and then take a 15-minute break and come back? It's actually a very psychological thing. It's there in the our Shastras. Okay, now you start. Morning, you have to get up at 1:30. 1:30, the whole period gets over by what time? 3 o'clock. Even in professional colleges, the timetable is 1.5 hours. I remember 1.5 hours or 3 hours. That's the cycle with a break. So 1 to 3 o'clock, 3 to 4:30, 4:30 to 6, 6 to 7:30, 7:30 to 9, 9 to, so all this whole cycle till 9:30. Okay. So what are you supposed to do? Here is a secret. Raja Vidya, Guhya Vidya coming out. 1:30 you get up and do what? Do what? Pranayama. No, pranayama ke liye time 4 baje ke baad hai. 1:30 ke baad 2 periods. 1:30 to 3 o'clock and 3 to 4:30. You are supposed to do something very strategic in nature. You are supposed to meet your spies. Spies? You pura raat bhar ghumte rehte. And you do secret mission activities. दुनिया को दुनिया सोई है हम काम कर रहे हैं. 3 o'clock to 4:30 you are actually taking advices from the military leaders. See, look at this very strategically. Spying system is different from the military system. Okay, so पहले spy को पूछते हैं कैसे चल रहा है military वाले, and therefore this is saying about spying and counter spying. And then before the world wakes up, the leader knows what is happening in the kingdom. Wow. Ab suno, the people will get up at 4 o'clock, 4:30, right? That's our traditional Brahma mode cycle. But even before the world has woken up, you are ready. And I found this very interesting. Even in modern day time management productive leaders, they finish off their work before they actually go to office. Are you aware of this? You start reading this, you'll be surprised. So what they say, when I'm in the morning, that 1.5 hours of productivity, I can write, I can think, I can document, I can plan, isn't it? And I have seen it in the corporate world also. I know this particular Mr. Vijayan, and his office used to start always at 9 o'clock. And he used to be in office at 8 o'clock. They were like, yeah, sabse pehle, you are the chairman of a company, the director of a company, why are you going 1 hour early? And he says, you know, because my people come at 9 o'clock, but the work gets over before 9 o'clock. What is my role as a chairman? My job is to think, isn't it? Thinking cannot happen in a crowd. Thinking is a lonely activity. So 1:30 to 3 o'clock, you are thinking. इसलिए सुबह उठ के क्या करना है ये मत पूछो, सुबह उठ के क्या सोचना है ये पूछो. what you think makes you day, right? And he says you have to think the policy structures. Then, 4:30 onwards you get up, you do all your physical activities. 6 o'clock you are ready, correct? Then you go. Then there is a lot of spiritual ritual activities, traditional Gaya Mata ka puja karna, go and meet your parents, all those things. And then 7:30 it starts. Office starts. I want to ask you one thing. When the Raja goes to the office, what is the first activity he is supposed to do? Raja jabhi darbar mein jata hai, sabse pehle kya karna chahiye? What are you supposed to do? अपनी जय जयकार कर, साय वाले मोटे साय वाले उठा उठा. His first time is given to कोषाध्यक्ष, अकाउंटेंट के साथ बैठना. क्या बात कर रहे हैं सर? राजा को प्रजा से मिलना चाहिए बाद में, बिकॉज प्रजा विल ओनली कम विथ प्रॉब्लम, बट ऑल प्रॉब्लम इज सॉल्व थ्रू मनी. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड प्रैक्टिकल. The person who can control finance can control everything, isn't it true? And it's a problem that we only look at the bank accounts during the tax filing day. And the people who have made money know that activity of money has to be on a daily basis, isn't it true? So Chanakya ne aisa training diya, he was the first philosopher who says, Artha eva pradhanaha. The world runs on money. And money is not about being money minded, huh? Money is being money conscious. There's a difference in being money minded and being money conscious. Paise ke liye kaam nahi karta hai, lekin paise ke saath kaam karna padta hai, isn't it? And he says one of the biggest activity for project management is budgeting, isn't it true? Pehla soch lo kitna kal lagega, kaun log lagenge. So the first thing the Raja does is that he sits with the koshadaksha and simple, kitna aaya kitna gaya. Is it discussion, outstanding kitna hai? I'll give you an example. I do a lot of consultancy with business groups. So one of the person who was a managing director of a company, so he was attending my program. And then after 3 months, he called me and he told, you know, Radha, there's a big difference in my business activity. So, kya ho gaya? Matlab aap hi ne sikha, maine kya sikha? Chanakya ne sikha, kya? You know, I used to always get into my office, 9 o'clock, actually I used to get by 9:30 only. So already the activity has started. And the first thing when I go into office, my secretary will come in, all the people will come in, the marketing people will come in, kada 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 kada, the dunya ka pura bojh chal hota tha. And then time to time I realized my finance is not under control. But when I heard that Chanakya has said, and then I also mentioned, in the Marwadi community there is something called as the Partha system. Have you heard about the Partha system? You should study all this in Greek traditional models. Now it's getting more modernized. Partha system matlab kya, it's a simple one page note. So the Marwadi community is a fantastic case study. You know, they may not be so-called literate in the MBA thing, but they understand the sense of money flow. So in the Partha system, that businessman will have a one-page note given by that Munimji. So kya one-page note? Kitna aaya, kitna gaya, kitna bacha. That's it. Baki detail tumhara. There is a difference between accounting and understanding finance. People get into accounting so much, it becomes a number game. That is an accountant's job. But financial acumen is what a businessman should know, isn't it? Acumen is different. Wo bolte na pulse. Wo bolta hai chartered accountant, uska kaam karne do na, mere ko mera kaam karne do. I will make money, he will count money. Difference. So, why am I telling all these things, friends? When I told my friend, he said, you know what? It suddenly hit to me, mera swadharma kya hai? As a businessman, what is your swadharma? Chanakya is making money, isn't it true? If you are a grahasthashrami, aapko paisa banana hai aapke family ke liye, isn't it true? So then I realized ki probably I get into a business activity in a firefighting mode rather than a strategic financial planning mode. You see the difference? Office mein jaate hai, sab log aayenge, phone aayega, mobile aayega, WhatsApp aayega. The first activity we do in the morning when we go anywhere is WhatsApp mein kya hai. It's a good tool, but it should not use you, you should use it. Even in government records now, WhatsApp is accepted as an official communication. But the thing is that you have to understand the first 1.5 hours when you get into activity, do the core priority activity. I don't know what your priority is. If you're a businessman, that's your priority, isn't it true? I tell you, I've seen a sports coach. He said, first 1.5 hours when you almost sikha, then wo din bar yaad rehta, isn't it true? So when this businessman actually said, my swadharma is to make money and not, I'm not even focused on my money. Every time the chartered accountant says, ye karna hai, wo karna hai, and I made a system with my PA that before you leave in the night, okay, tumhara time, aapko daily, that it's called financial dashboard in the management terminologies, okay. One pager, like a parda system, kitna hai, kitna gaya, and it will have all the details of the clients, all those things, expenses, ek table pe rakh dega. And it should happen that your job will not get done till your report is ready. And the CA, sorry, the PA would come next day, but he would come there at 9 o'clock sharp, and people are expecting him to make. Well, like, 15 minute, main meditation kar raha hu. Meditation matlab ke analysis kar raha hu, financial figures. 9 to 9:15 every day, I started looking at the numbers. And it just made me conscious and aware what the position of my business is. Just that in 3 months, his whole business got revived. From debt to positivity. Chanakya Niti on daily life. My dear friends, we have to understand this, that if you are spending time with the Koshadhyaksha, it is a very important time. Like, you know, he's a finance officer and in a corporate world called a CFO, Chief Financial Officer, whatever, whatever. When we are small also, in an individual family also we can use it. And I always say that, you know, women have an understanding of money which is very different from men. Isn't it true? They have an acumen. And every wife has got a secret account which the husband doesn't know. True? Now this account is not a selfish account. It is an account that is for crisis management. It will come out during demonetization. So we come back to Chanakya's daily timetable. Then, once you look at the accounting, then you get into Praja. 1.5 hours spent time with Praja. And Praja will be any kind of, look at any politician that you involved. Wo subah 7 baje uthta hai to seedha bedroom mein aa jata hai. Mera gaay gum ho gaya. Are gaay gum ho gaya re, mere ko daant to ghasne the, wo tum baad mein ghaso, maine vote diya hai tere ko. So you have to deal with anybody and everybody when you're a king. The most poorest of the poor would come from a village, the richest of the rich businessmen will come for a deal and say, you know, give us a good policy, whatever, whatever. Then you get into a lot of activities and a lot of things. And remember one thing, Chanakya says, the king should not become a businessman, but he should understand business and make good policies for business to flourish. Correct, yeah? A leader should not become a trader, but leader should understand trading, right? And problem kya hota hai ki whenever we start thinking about politicians making economic policy, we say corruption. Corruption comes because you are a leader, but you are actually thinking like a trader or a dealer. Chanakya says, understand business. Well, I don't think so. He in fact has a sabha and a samiti, advisors of the king who are actually businessmen, wealth creators. And they're very good, huh? Because tax collections come from them, the productivity comes from them, etc. etc. So till 12 o'clock, there is a lot of activity. Then something interestingly happens because dhoop chad gayi hai na upar tak. Then suddenly you can take a break. The natural system dupahar ko sote hai. Sote ke nahi sote hai? So ded ghanta khana peena thoda dekh lo. But what is important is that at 12 o'clock, when you are a little bit ready between 10:30, 12 and all those things, you are supposed to study for 1.5 hours. The most busiest person has to study for 1.5 hours daily. Sab ho gaya, firefighting people ko mil liya, accounts dekh liya, shant ho gaya, you know what's happening. Now go and do swadhyaya. Amcha ikada aata mala 15 minute jaun Yaneshwari la bagala time nahi hai. And ikada deed ta swadhyayan kara. Ani lokana bolvayacha, guruji na bolvayacha, and they used to have a debate and discussion on a daily basis. Kya lagta hai aapko? And then 1:30 is a little bit tired and he can take a break. So, and then he starts, 3 o'clock he's back into action, he goes out for some sports activity. So, dhoop kam ho raha hai na. Then he goes and checks all the hathi, ghoda, sab theek hai, you know. And slowly 6 o'clock ho gaya. Then again he meets people. He spends time with his family and all those things. And then he has his meals, everything. And he sleeps at 9 o'clock. So how many hours in a day he sleeps? 6 hours. 9 o'clock to 1:30 in the night, remember? And the afternoon, 1.5 hours if required. But some people say, nahi, huh? Let me tell you, my dear friends, it is not the length of the sleep that matters, it is the depth of the sleep that matters. Isn't it true? It is not the quantity of sleep, it is the quality of sleep. If your mind is composed, you require less sleep. And if you're depressed, even if you keep sleeping, you can't sleep, right? So there's a lot of mental way of looking at things. So while coming to a little bit of an end, I'm going to just take another 5 minutes to tell you what we can learn and what we can practice. But before that, I want to tell you, when Chanakya makes this, you know, सुबह उठ के ये करने का ये करने का, all this perfect plan, timetable. But the end of the 19th chapter, he says something very interesting. The king is supposed to follow these rules on a daily basis, but very important. Looking at priorities of the day, he can change it. वरना क्या हो जाएगा? Timetable देखते-देखते main objective हो जाएगा. You know, we can have a schedule, but that schedule should not become rigid. It has to be flexible, isn't it true? Depending on what is the priority of the day. Like for example, there are a lot of people who do upasanas of certain devi, devata, whatever, they have taken a sankalp, you know. And then what happens? Nahi, mala ek tas mala parayan karaycho ahe. And ya time mala parayan karnarach, karana changli hai. तो चांगला एक सिद्धांत आहे, एक संकल्प संकल्प घेतलेला आहे. बट यु नो व्हॉट हॅपन्स, समटाइम्स दॅट बिकम्स रिजिडिटी, इजंट इट ट्रू? अरे उस टाइम में, उसी समय में कोई बच्चा को अगर कुछ बीमार हो गया, व्हाट विल द मदर डू? भगवान सॉरी, मेरे को ये देखना, इजंट इट? आज हम एक घंटा नहीं पढ़ सकती, दो मिनट पढ़ लो, दैट्स अ प्रायोरिटी. सो किंग कैन नॉट से नाउ इट इज माय टाइम टू लुक एट अकाउंट्स, ओके लुक एट अकाउंट्स, बट देयर इज एन एनिमी कमिंग. वो आ गया एनिमी को रुकने को, बोलो क्योंकि मेरे गुरुजी ने बोला है सुबह सुबह उठ के अकाउंट्स देखने का. राम राम राम. तो चाणक्य सेज, ही गोस टू अदर एक्सटेंट ऑफ इवन टेलिंग दैट एवरी लीडर्स कैपेबिलिटी इज नॉट द सेम. आर यू अवेयर ऑफ दिस? अरे उसको सुबह डेढ़ बजे उठता है, अरे डेढ़ बजे उठता है, लेकिन जब एज होता है तुम थोड़ा कम आराम से उठो. So he also says that even though I've defined a timetable, the person has to choose wisely how much to follow the timetable. Otherwise, rules become rigid and that becomes a problem. Now that's practicality, isn't it true? So 3-4 things I would suggest to you friends. How many of you have a daily timetable? And do you do it as a self-discipline or external discipline? बच्चे लोग तो ना छोटे, मम्मी उठाती है तो उठते हैं. But you know what maturity says, that we need to be self-disciplined. It's a very important word. So I'll tell you a small joke of a mother who was actually waking up her son and said, beta, utho, school jana hai. Beta says, mama, sone do. After 5-10 minutes, beta, utho, school jana hai. Mama, sone do na aur 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, beta, utho, school jana hai. Itna to yaad rakho, tum school ke principal ho. बेटा उठ के बोलता, मम्मा तुम भी याद रखो मैं स्कूल का प्रिंसिपल हूं. द मदर हैज नॉट फॉरगॉटन हर रोल, शी इज गॉट स्टक टू अ रोल. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दिस, पेरेंटिंग इज अ रोल बट इट बिकम्स योर आइडेंटिटी. अंडरस्टैंड, वो स्कूल का प्रिंसिपल है, उसको मालूम है कब जाना है, ही इज गॉट फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. कल रात को बेचारा 2 बजे आया था. So, we have to understand one thing, if that person has to get up on his own, that is real self-discipline, isn't it? So what I'm saying, my dear friends, as parents also and grandparents also, let me tell you one thing. Our thing, Chanakya says this, you know, how to bring up your children. There are 5 years, love him or her. Next 10 years, discipline them. After 15 years, consider them your friends. 15 saal ke baad, usko aap, bachcho, main tera baap hu, tu hai na? I am your father, मैंने इतनी बारिश देखी है, ठीक है. You will lose your son. He should be a friend, isn't it true? But what happens? You still become a parent when a child is actually ready to become a parent. So Chanakya says that, you know, nothing should be rigid in our life. It has to be flexible. But please understand this, clarity with flexibility. A lot of people are flexible, they don't know what to do. They're so loose, no purpose in life. Have a purpose, have an agenda, have a strategy, have a timetable, have a purpose, everything. But when time comes, it's like Mother Ganga starting from Gomukh going to Ganga Sagar. Aisa nahi ki straight line hai. Dheere dheere, tumhe bada patthar dekha to side mein se nikal gaya, chota patthar to upar se nikal gaya. And then you come to Prayagraj, Allahabad, you know. Wow, there is lot of space. Jara bhago sangam, Triveni sangam. Then again you go out. But finally, doesn't forget, mera ultimate objective is to meet with the sea, isn't it? My dear friends, Chanakya was very clear on the purpose. If you have a purpose, if you have a sankalpa, okay, please study the Chanakya Niti. And I tell you, in life, small things matter. Become financially conscious, become money conscious, but don't become money minded. use power, but don't misuse power. And lastly, I'd like to stop by telling you one of the greatest lessons that Chanakya gave in Chanakya Niti. And he says, ek leader ko, or ek achhe individual ko, I'm saying leader, any good individual, should know when to stop in life. Genius is to know when to stop. Aapka kaam jab ho gaya na, nikal jao. Before people tell you to get out, you should walk out gracefully, isn't it? Please understand, the next generation jab ready ho jata hai na, you should know, beta, beto gaddi pe, main chala. Lekin aap jao main. Woh chahte hai tum jaye, tum jao. That is why Mahendra Singh Dhoni is respected, isn't it true? Nobody removed him, but he said, no, the next leader is ready. Aaja Virat, I'm there with you as a Margadarshan. I'm still playing. And nobody remembers how many centuries Dhoni has made. You know how many centuries he's made? No. Captaincy is about getting results. He got na World Cup bhi mila, wo bhi mila, abhi Chennai bhi mila. He is a leader who says, my purpose is the team has to win, the game has to win. The game has to be bigger than the player. But when the time comes, before you tell me to get out, I know how to get out. मुझे निकालने की जरूरत नहीं है, मैं निकल जाऊंगा. लेकिन निकलने से पहले सेकंड लेवल ऑफ लीडरशिप तैयार करके जाऊंगा. सी दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट. आई विल नॉट लीव द होल इंस्टीट्यूशन इन डोल्ड्रम्स. एंड देयरफॉर द चाणक्य सूत्र सेज, फॉर द सेक ऑफ द विलेज लीव योर फैमिली. फॉर इंडिविजुअल शुड लीव हिमसेल्फ फॉर द सेक ऑफ द फैमिली, इजंट इट? द फैमिली इज बिगर देन द इंडिविजुअल. अपने परिवार के लिए स्वयं का त्याग कर दो. फॉर द सेक ऑफ द विलेज लीव योर फैमिली, बिकॉज देयर आर सो मेनी फैमिलीज व्हेन यू बिकम अ विलेज हेड. For the sake of the country, leave your village. Isn't it? Maybe when a person from a local corporator becomes an MLA to an MP or whatever, you know. And then he says, for the sake of the country, leave your village. And for the sake of the world, leave the country. Jab vishwa star pe na desh vesh nahi rehta. And for the sake of the other world, leave this world also. And this is not runaway. This is not runaway. Is actually the त्याग की भावना. मैंने अपना काम किया है, पूरी तरह किया है. I did my life perfectly and I'm walking out with grace and saying that आगे की पीढ़ी अपना काम करेगी. मैंने किताब भी लिख दिया. If they want a reference, it is there in the book. I've created a leadership generation. I created a great country. And when I die, I will tell myself, I'm finally reporting to him, the Lord above. And I feel if I face him, I say, wow, बेटा अच्छा काम किया, आ जा. अरे फ्रेंड्स, चाणक्य इन डेली लाइफ छोटी छोटी बात होती है, लेकिन जीवन के अंत में आप पीछे देखोगे ना, तो बोलेंगे हाँ, मैंने अपने जिंदगी में वी फाउंड सक्सेस एट एवरी पॉइंट. आई वुड लाइक टू से माय फ्रेंड्स दैट चाणक्य वाज अ पर्सनालिटी, वाज अ फिलोसोफर, अ स्ट्रेटजिस्ट, अ किंग मेकर, बट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट ही वाज अ गुरु हु टुक यू टू द स्पिरिचुअल पाथ ऑफ मोक्ष ऑल्सो. बट डोंट कन्फ्यूज मोक्ष बिफोर यू एक्चुअली डू योर कर्म. कर्म करते करते मोक्ष पे जाएंगे, ओके? लेकिन हमारा प्रॉब्लम है मोक्ष करते करते कर्म भूल जाते हैं. डू योर वर्क विदाउट अटैचमेंट, वैराग्य के साथ, और फल की प्राप्ति होगी. ऑल ऑफ यू हैव रेड द भगवद गीता एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स. बट चाणक्य इज अ प्रैक्टिकल फिलोसोफर हु सेज, बी वर्ल्डली सक्सेसफुल एंड स्पिरिचुअली सक्सेसफुल. ओनली वर्ल्डली सक्सेसफुल पीपल कैन बिकम स्पिरिचुअली सक्सेसफुल. स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज नॉट अ रन अवे. कुछ नहीं किया, शादी भी नहीं हुआ, नौकरी भी नहीं होता, बाबा जी बन गए. I am successful, therefore I am spiritually successful. I hope you will understand this part of Chanakya, practice it somewhere, and be a role model for other people around you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Once again, thank you to all the audiences, Shreya, Sagar, and Chairman Sir, Mr. Sunil Rai Soni, VC Sir, Dr. Rajan Velukar Sir, Mrs. Pillai, thank you so much. And the photos and some clips will be available on our website. It's www.sgrkf.com. SGR Knowledge Foundation. It's sgrkf.com. You will find the details of next program also there. And you can put the suggestions of yours or the feedback of yours on the mobile number which we have given in the on the posters and in the SMS also. Can we have some questions? The forum is open for the questions, so as early as possible we will cover the questions as well. Please.
Yes. How did it display? Very important question. A lot of people ask me this, and I said, I am not interested in how Chanakya died. was interested in how we lived. Now coming back, there are a lot of theories around it, and I'm not a historian. So the versions that go is that after he made Chandragupta Maurya the king, he actually went back to the forest. He started running a Gurukul, and that's the time when he wrote the Arthashastra and all those things. So one version says that, you know, he had an accidental death. There's another version that says that he was actually killed. And that's a very popular version. And we scholars also don't think, Chanakya ko kaun marega yaar? Come on. So the thing is that there are people who say that he was finally killed. I don't accept it. But what is very important is that it seems he lived a very matured life to such an extent that he actually went into the Vanvayas and the Sanyas spirit, and that's where the reference we get it in the Jaina scriptures. If you know Chandragupta Maurya and later on his grandson Ashoka, they took to the path of Sanyas in their own way. If you look at it, so Chandragupta Maurya was influenced by Jain Munis towards his life, and of course Ashoka took Buddhism in his life. So it said that, you know, Chanakya at that particular period, he took Sanyas formally and then slowly passed away. But that one moment how he died, was it because of a heart attack? I don't know. But the whole idea is that before he died, he did something which is a life worth living, right? So as they say, instead of asking how he died, ask how he lived. So historically, I don't know. But these are the versions that are available.
What was Chanakya's time period? What was he following?
Oh, very good. Very good point. Very good point. You know, this is a story where when Chanakya used to actually be the Rajguru, and think about it, कि आपका शिष्य राजा है और मैं तो दंडे के दिल सुबह उठो ये करो वो करो irritating ना every day you have to get up what your guru says. तो some people, you know, they are the chamchas of the rajas, you know what the पूरा राज्य क्या बोलता है. राज्य बोलते हैं कि आप अपने गुरु चाणक्य के अंडर एक कठपुतली हो. So you follow everything that you don't have a personal life only. So one day Chandragupta gets very irritated. He goes to Chanakya and says, yes, look to me as a timetable, but I can make many follow karne wale, all those things. Because you are relaxing in that particular ashram and I am working 24/7. Aisa nahi chalega. You know, Chanakya says, tumko kya lagta hai, main aaram karta hoon. And he says, very powerful. He says, do log hai, jinko apne naseeb mein aaram nahi likha gaya. Ek hai shashak, tu, aur dusra hai shikshak, main. Do you think I have an easy life? I have to control you, who controls the whole world. So Chanakya's life was more self-disciplined to make the whole kingdom disciplined, right? And I'll tell you something very interesting. Hamari yahan pe, we have forgotten the real Indian philosophy. The Indian philosophy is not the stories of Rajas. They're the stories of the philosophers who guided Rajas, isn't it true? Shivaji without Ramdas Maharaj is not complete. And who are the Rajagurus? They were Acharyas, isn't it? Now, Acharya is not just a Guru. He is a very Shastriya madhe abhyas kelela manus asto to. So if you look at Shankaracharya, Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, these are some of the, or Vallabhacharya, this is some of the prominent Acharya. Or if you look at the modern Acharya, so if you look at Swami Vivekananda, or Swami Chinmayananda for that particular matter, you'll be surprised, the word Acharya has got a lot of depth. It has got a lot of scholarships in it. So, हमारे यहाँ पे the acharyas has to study. It is called swadhyaya, and in Taittiriya Upanishad swadhyaya pravachanecha. Heard about that? So, तुम्ही अभ्यास कराने शिकवा. The teacher is more busy than the king because he is creating the next generation of leaders. So, if the king has to wake up, he also has to wake up. In fact, the king is temporary, isn't it? But the chair is permanent. So, after this king goes, the next king is created by me. So coming back to what is Chanakya's timetable, as he said, you know, Sikshak or Sakshak, dono ko aaram nahi milta. Responsibility.
This is what you have understood, Chanakya.
Yeah.
What has happened today in his own land now? What has gone wrong?
Can you repeat your question?
That is what you have understood Chanakya to be. What has gone wrong now today?
Today in what scenario?
In today's scenario. In the political scenario.
Whatever. Simple thing is that we don't follow the instructions of our Indian philosophy. I want all of you to read something called as Taittiriya Upanishad. And when somebody studies and parts out, there is a Diksha ceremony. Taittiriya Upanishad very clearly says there are so many chapters on that, but I'll tell you a few of them. When a student is passing out of the Gurukul, we have this convocation ceremony, isn't it? And then he's given advice. अभी पढ़ाई हो गया, अभी तू फ्री है. फ्री है नहीं है, अभी जो जो सिखाओ प्रैक्टिस करना है. I'm going to repeat and summarize what you should do in daily life. So the commandments are सत्यम वद, धर्मम चर, मातृ देवो भव, पितृ देवो भव, आचार्य देवो भव, अतिथि देवो भव, स्वाध्याय प्रवचने च, अन्नम ब्रह्म. Now when you're coming out of the Gurukul, you have to practice this, not because the government says. You have to practice satyam vada, speak the truth. Abhi bolte hai, truth. Dharmam chara, apna dharma karo. What is your swadharma? If you are a grahastha, you have to earn money, take care of others. Okay? If you are a vanaprastha, you have to pass on the knowledge. Satyam vada, dharmam chara. Acharya devo bhava, matru devo bhava, pitru devo bhava. All this you have to practice. And most important, in the most busiest life also, swadhyaya pravajane cha. एव्हरी डे स्वाध्याय करा. काहीतरी आपल्या शास्त्राचं ज्ञानेश्वरी असेल की दासबोध असेल, आय डोंट नो, डिपेंडिंग ऑन डिफरंट कल्चर्स. इफ यू गो टू द नॉर्थ यू हॅव तुलसी रामायण, इफ यू गो टू द साऊथ यू हॅव डिफरंट बुक, बट वी हॅव रिजनल बुक्स ऑल्सो. ग्रेट सेंट्स आचार्यज हॅव रिटन इट. स्वाध्याय करो अँड देन प्रवचने च, प्रवचन भी दो. हमारे यहाँ पे गुरुकुल सिस्टम और युनिव्हर्सिटी सिस्टम इज नॉट इन स्कूल्स अँड कॉलेजेस, इट इज इन एव्हरी हाऊस. आमच्या इकडे टीचिंग, सॉरी, लर्निंग अँड टीचिंग इज अन ऍक्टिव्हिटी टिल यू डाई. आता ना माझं ग्रॅज्युएशन झालं, ग्रॅज्युएशन झाल्यानंतर अभ्यास कर. राजाला सांगितलं ना, 1.5 तास प्रत्येक दिवशी अभ्यास कर आणि प्रवचन पण कर. घरी बसून ज्ञानेश्वरांचे बाबा त्या चारही मुलांना ज्ञानेश्वरी आणि त्याचं नॉलेज दिलं की नाही दिलं? सो वी हॅव टू बी टीचर्स इन द हाऊस, वी डोंट हॅव टू हॅव टीचर्स आउटसाइड. दॅट इज ऑल्सो दॅट. सो वेअर द प्रॉब्लेम इज स्टार्टेड दॅट वी डोंट स्टडी आवर स्क्रिप्चर्स. आपण काय करतो, टीव्ही बघतो. टीव्ही बघा, व्हॉट्सअप बघा, पण 1.5 तास. ओके, 1.5 तास नाही जमत, 1 तास ते पण नाही जमत. 15 मिनिटं तरी स्वाध्याय करा आणि 15 मिनिटं सांगा. यु नो, आय टेल यू द बिगेस्ट पेन आय सी इन द सोसायटी, ग्रँड पेरेंट्स अँड ग्रँड चिल्ड्रन आर नॉट गेटिंग कनेक्टेड. दॅट इज द डेथ ऑफ अ कल्चर. ग्रँड पेरेंट्स डोंट नो व्हॉट टू स्पीक टू ग्रँड चिल्ड्रन. व्हॉट अ कंडिशन. अँड आय टेल यू, वी कांट से यु नो आता आम्ही एकत्र नाही आहेत आणि ते टीव्ही बघतात. टीव्ही बघतात पण तुम्ही सांगत नाही. जोक विच इज यु नो, वाय आर द ग्रँड पेरेंट्स अँड द ग्रँड चिल्ड्रन क्लोज टू इच अदर? बिकॉज दे हॅव अ कॉमन एनिमी इन बिटवीन. मुलं, छोटी मुलं फक्त आई आजोबांचेच ऐकणार आहेत, बरोबर आहे की नाही? पण आई आजोबांना सांगायला काय नाही ना. आम्ही पण चाललो अमेरिकाच्या टूर मध्ये, तुम्ही जा बघा. The problem is not a political problem, it's a social problem, isn't it? Because politics also emerges from the same society. I work with so many politicians who are my very close friends, and they say that he corrupt, and then they say, you know what, the society corrupted. Then I say, there is some truth in that. Understand this, a country which is continuously focused on knowledge becomes a knowledge society. That country will elect a knowledgeable leader, isn't it true? And you know, one politician told me this, but mere ko to simple sa aadmi mein normal family sa. The day I became a politician, was elected as an MLA, first time one businessman came and told me, ye kar do na. To bola, ha, main dekhta hu kya karna hai. Pehli baar bola, aapko kya chahiye? Main sir, aapko kya chahiye? Bole ki 2 din laga samajhne ke liye, he is bribing me. My dear friends, so for me, political problems are jyada, as Swami Chinmayanand used to tell, the individuals make a society and society makes a nation, isn't it? To Bharat ka kya hoga? Arre chodo Bharat ka kya hoga, mera kya hoga, mere ghar walon ka kya hoga, dekho. I wanted to watch that movie called 102 Not Out. Dekha ki nahi dekha? It's a gap of the society. Children and parents are not getting connected. So my point is that please read some scripture on a daily basis, swadhyay karo. And I am telling you friends, tumhi darkate ya आत्मसंशोधन, आत्मनिरीक्षण करायला लागला ना, यू बी रेस्पेक्टेड इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर कंट्री. थँक यू. आय विल टेक अप युअर सेल्फ, कम बॅक.
इट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट टू नो युअर सेल्फ, यू टू बिकम अ गुड लीडर.
या,
व्हॉट इज द बेस्ट वे टू नो युअर सेल्फ?
या, द बेस्ट वे टू नो युअर सेल्फ, इट्स कॉल्ड वृद्ध संयोग. वृद्ध म्हणजे पीपल आर मोर एक्सपीरियंस, नॉलेजेबल अँड हायर दॅन यू. उनके साथ रहो, धीरे धीरे आपको बता देंगे क्या करना. So Chanakya says, if you want to develop any talent, including leadership talent, be surrounded by more leaders. So if you are like, you know, let's say, from business term, you have a 5 crore company. If you surround yourself with people who got a 50 crore company, they will tell you how to run a 50 crore company and you get elevated. So surround yourself with more leaders to become better leader. Yeah.
Sir, Sir, every time we go to such a talk, we try to do everything that the speaker told us. But our willpower doesn't cooperate. So anything Chanakya said on willpower.
Okay, very good point. First of all, don't use the word we, I. Don't generalize. Willpower is something that is human beings' greatest asset. Only human beings can have willpower. A bird doesn't have willpower. वो अंडे से बाहर आने तक willpower है. उसको nature ने एक limitation दी. It can fly, it can swim, whatever till a particular. Human beings can go beyond it. But you know, willpower can only be developed by self-disciplined people. We want aram and willpower. Oh, Swami Vivekananda's guru, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa said, if you want to develop willpower, take the first step. God will take 10 steps towards you. So, pehle sankalp lo. I hope all of you understand the concept of sankalp. Sankalp is not, you know, wish. It is an oath. Bhishma pratignya bolta hai, ye karunga, kuch bhi aaye karunga. And to stick on to it. So, what I am saying is that instead of developing big, big projects with willpower, start with small. Take one project as a sankalp, develop it. And see that, you know, instead of all the projects, and the moment you complete, you feel, wow. Then automatically, that small willpower take a bigger project, develop it. And then it becomes a part of your personality. So, number one, I would request all of you, which probably I am seeing that if you attend such talks, which always, you know, sort of, yeah, see, let me tell you, my dear friends, I am not a motivational speaker. Pep talk. I'm a thinker, right? But what I find is that in India we like to listen so much, but we never take notes. Swadhyay kidhar ho raha hai yahan pe? It's a class, isn't it true? So next time onwards, I'm happy that sir is organizing one speaker every time. Please get some notepads if you can. Apne ghar se leke aao. I'm at least happy it's video recorded. Iske upar chintan manan karo, isn't it? I'm sure it's going to be uploaded. See it again and again. And yahan mantar abhyas, repetition. लहानपणा चांगलं होतं आपलं सिस्टम मारून मारून ते धडे शिकवायचे परत परत सांगा 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 आजकाल जरा टेक्नॉलॉजी ना सो व्हॉट यू हॅव रिपीटेड चिंतन मनन निधिध्य असेल आता चिंतन करा प्रॅक्टिस करा अँड फायनली यू विल बिकम एन एक्सपर्ट सर
दशरथ राजा एज वॉज 60,000 years
Actually, Paral Sangitadara, I am not a historian, so I don't know age-wise 60-20. But as far as Chanakya is concerned, I am looking at, in fact, I have already spoken to some Jyotish people, astrologers, and we are trying to get the Janma Tithi of Acharya Chanakya. I am working on that particular project. Because hum log kehte hai Ram Navami ya Krishna Janmashtami, right? There is a tithi that you have found out and you celebrate it, right? Guru Purnima is the birthday of Vyasa. Unfortunately, the actual birth of Chanakya, at least I am not aware of it. So I am trying to find out. I have put some very good Jyotish scholars in the field. So maybe in the next 1 year I will be able to find out and I will share it with you. Yeah. Yeah.
Sure.
Now it's a very interesting question. Having the knowledge of Sanskrit is an advantage, but it is not essential. Lot of people have mentioned about Sanskrit, but I don't know how to do it. There are a lot of translations available in Marathi, in English, a lot of other languages. Let me correct you, ma'am, that I never studied Sanskrit and then studied Arthashastra. Actually, I studied Arthashastra and then I realized my English version kyun padh raha. Afterwards, I did my MA in Sanskrit. Huh? So, my love for understanding Arthashastra started by the English one. In fact, there is a great scholar, his name is R.P. Kangale. He has translated the original Sanskrit into Marathi as well as English. Mumbai University ke professor the Wilson College mein, 1950s year later. My interest in Sanskrit only grew with time after I studied Arthashastra. For all of you, if you don't know Sanskrit, it's okay. Swami Chinmayananji was a great teacher of Bhagavad Gita. Same people asked him, do I require the knowledge of Sanskrit to study the Bhagavad Gita? And he said, if you have the knowledge of Sanskrit, it's an advantage, but it is not an essential. First start studying the Gita, interest in Sanskrit will automatically come. Okay, we'll have the last one or two.
Next to this, that was the last question actually. All the 6000 sutras what you have mentioned, are those also available online somewhere?
Yeah, yes, yes.
So
You can do some Google search, but remember, Google search is not research. So do some actual research, and I can help you. Okay.
I was just wondering with the channels
they
have an acharya.
Of course. Many acharyas. The Arthashastra refers to 14 acharyas. Some acharyas who actually were trained in his generation, but some purva acharyas. In the Sanskrit literature, there is something called as purva paksha and uttara paksha. Do you know this concept? There's a debate discussion, purva paksha. So there are purva acharyas from whom I studied also. So they read the books, debated, discussed. But his immediate acharya was his own father. His name was Chanakya. Chanakya putra Chanakya. That's how he's got the name. His original name was Vishnugupta. And Kautilya was his Gotra name. So Kutila Diti we bolte hai, Kutila Gotra bolte hai. So Chanakya's immediate guru, as one guru figure, was his father called Chanakya. But he had so many previous acharyas like Vishona, the Narad Muni he read. Because Narad Muni was also a political thinker. If you look at Narada Niti, you will see all of them. So many acharyas, but primarily Chanakya. Last question, sir.
As you said, Chanakya had was a great strategist,
yeah.
And he had knowledge about every field, like
yeah.
The thing,
yeah.
Right from in every part of
the yeah.
From
yeah.
Wars as to the parenting.
Yes, yes.
So what was the reason that he didn't use knowledge for himself? So all his knowledge was used to make somebody a king.
Right.
Had he been ambitious, he could have become emperor himself.
Yeah.
So what was the reason?
Okay, a very interesting question. Who is more stronger, king or kingmaker? Pehli baat, knowledge you cannot give it to others till you are full of knowledge. Huh? Knowledge is not meant for others. Yahan pe lecture sunke dusro ko lecture mat do. Aaj suna, abhi main sunata hu. Arre bhaiya, practice karo. Therefore they say that knowledge which is imbibed in you, it becomes so full that automatically it has to come out. Therefore I like Jnaneshwari's background. You know, who was Jnaneshwar's guru? His own elder brother. And he was so full of knowledge that Nivritti Maharaj Jata Liya Baba, Jnaneshwari was. So he was so full that Nivritti Maharaj said, now you have to start. And by the way, if you know, there is a place called as Nevasa. I hope you have gone to all these places. It's a pretty fantastic place. That Jnaneshwar Maharaj actually gave the Pravachan of Bhagavad Gita in a local Marathi language. He was so full, young little boy. And I'm telling you, friends, knowledge, swadhyaya pravachane cha, barobar hai na? Pravachan ani nantar swadhyay na hai. Kiwa pravachana sathi swadhyay na hai. I want to give a lecture, so I will acquire knowledge. No, acquire knowledge, 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 knowledge. And one day, even if you say one line, that is knowledge. It is not public performance, it is not public speaking skills. Swami Vivekananda never attended a public speaking skill and never practiced. My dear sisters and brothers of America, हम लोग जाके बोलो कोई खड़ा भी नहीं करेगा. Because those words came from the depth of silence. Those words were meditative words. They were representation of a culture. तब जाके हमको पता चलता है कि knowledge is to be distributed, but first you digest knowledge, make it a part of yourself. Let me tell you, when the flower blooms, the bee from across the world will come to you, isn't it true? But हमारा क्या, आपको दुनिया भर जाना है, लेकिन अंदर का knowledge नहीं. So study and become great and be a great teacher. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, everybody, once again. Jawaya Jnaneshwara ni Jnaneshwari Lili Hoti, Tavaya Pasun Vachala Suruvat Keli. Ta Utar Vaya Varna Jasa.